hour. Well, there's been plenty of buzz about El Nino and what it could mean for the coming winter.
Yeah, new research shows El Nino's influence on California's rainy season isn't as strong as some headlines may suggest. Meteorologist Heather Waldman is here to explain. Heather.
Yeah, and the presence of El Nino or its complement La Nina can be one of the most robust clues that forecasters have about the coming winter. Those patterns are tracked by looking at sea surface temperatures. In general, the stronger the pattern, the better connections to certain temperature and precipitation trends. Models predict El Nino patterns pretty well, but they do a pretty poor job of predicting winter rain and snow patterns. Researchers at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory are trying to figure out why. A recent study shows that even a strong El Nino accounts for a small part of what drives our winter weather.
If you knew the El Nino precisely, you could kind of get 25% of the variance or the variability in the mid-latitudes. That's all it helps with. That means there's 75% of the signal that we experience in the mid-latitudes that, you know, we're still searching for how to predict that better and understand the process.
And one of those processes, the way that atmospheric rivers interact with West Coast storms. According to NASA, atmospheric rivers can provide moisture for up to half of California's yearly precipitation. But these atmospheric rivers can impact us with or without an El Nino. Just look at last year as an example. We had a weak La Nina pattern, which suggested the chance for a dry winter. But several storms brought quite a difference. Interacting with some of those atmospheric rivers and leading to over 20 inches of rain for downtown Sacramento between December, January, and February. Now, I did ask both study authors what they make of some of the winter outlooks that are floating around right now. They said that the current strong El Nino pattern gives them a little more confidence in those forecasts, but basing any forecast only on El Nino is unreliable, and for water managers, it can be risky.